బ్రహ్మాదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశ ఋషభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోపప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన ఘన ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ అష్టైశ్వర్యం అండ్ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షం టు యూ అండ్ యువర్ ఎంటైర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ టు. Let us begin Bhagavad Gita, chapter number 4, verse number 24. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Brahmarpanam Brahma Havihi Brahmagnau Brahmanahutam Brahmaivatena Gantavyam Brahmakarma Samadhina. This verse is very familiar verse for us. Because, so whoever knows little bit spiritual knowledge, they offer the food every time before starting to eat. We offer this Brahmarpanam with this mantra. Though this Vaidika method, they have Eko Vishnur Mahat Bhutam Prathak Bhutanyan Ekashaha Trin Lokan Vyapya Bhutatma Bhunte Vishwa Bhugavyayaha. So that is chanted there, but commonly now these words have become very famous to offer the food we used to chant. We usually chant these words. And this verse is known as Brahma Yajnam. Actually, this verse talks about Brahma Yajnam. Now, so this is the continuation of the last verse. In the last verse, గత సంగస్య ముక్తస్య జ్ఞానావస్థిత చేతసః, ద పర్సన్ వన్ హూ కెన్ పర్స్యూ బ్రహ్మన్ ఇన్ ఆల్ కర్మ, యునో కర్మణి బ్రహ్మదర్శనం, కర్మణి అకర్మ దర్శనం. దాట్స్ వాట్ ద టాపిక్ ఇస్ ఆన్ ఫర్ ద పాస్ట్ 6 వర్సెస్. సో వి బిగన్ కర్మణ్య కర్మ యః పశ్యేత్ అకర్మణి చ కర్మయః. When you are able to see Brahman in every action, with every form, everywhere, what happens is you are liberated from the karma phala. That practical example is given in this verse, that's all. You have to connect this verse to the previous verse, karman yah karma yah pashyat, that verse. So Brahma Darshanam is the matter of this verse. Brahma Darshanam means, so every object, it has got its own individuality. It means it has got its own limitations. So through all the limited object, can you pursue unlimited object, Akhandakara Brahma Vritti? It is known as Akhandakara Brahma Vritti. You see a non-different object, which is nothing but subject, into this all limited object. So how? So this is very difficult to understand. Okay, let me give an ancient example. So that example is nothing but a dream. In the dream, you are traveling towards Badrinath. You are a traveler. In the dream, you are one of the travelers. So you got a vehicle, you got a train. So train contains thousands of people. You are one among them. Station by station, you get so many things also for eating. You reached Delhi. From Delhi, you got the car. In the car, there are so many other people, maybe 12, 13 people with your that huge car. You reached Rishikesh or Haridwar. From there, you got another travel agency. You go with that people. You reached Badrinath. You had the darshan of Badrinath. Between, you had the darshan of Ganges, Gangaji. And you got the prasada. And you came to your home as you went with the help of all the travel materials. Now this is the dream. You enjoyed seeing Himalayas, mountains, rivers, and so many experience, means so many different people from different culture. Now, you experience yourself. So when you dream, that dream objects have not arrived from outside. Be careful. I'm making it very slow. When you dream, you saw a huge train in your dream, that which took you to Delhi. That huge train cannot enter into small body. Okay? Not only that, different people among there. And every station, so all the station has got its own announcement, its own shops and all. You saw all the shops. Could those all shops penetrate in you? No, it is impossible. And you reached the Delhi, is the huge station. You changed the from, you got down from the train and you passed, you know, you walked through the huge corridor steps and all, so it cannot penetrate in. So like that, you got the car, you got the people, you got lots of varieties of food, and you went on Himalayas mountain. It's a huge Himalayan mountain. How can it penetrate? How can it enter into your small body, mind and sense complex? You had not gone before Badrinath. It was the first time. So that, you know, the dream is not other than the dreamer. Okay? Now the train was projected by the conscious of the dreamer. Dreamer alone gives life. Dreamer alone gives the existence of the train, of the stations, of the New Delhi station, and to the cars, to the people, various people. And a dreamer has become many form. Dreamer has become Himalayas. He has not become Himalayas. He gives existence in the dream. When you come out of the dream, everything goes away. Where everything went away? Now I can use this language. You are nothing but station. You are nothing but train. You are nothing but the people around you experienced in the dream. You are nothing but you who were as a traveler in the dream, because you were lying down and sleeping on the cart, but you were having all the backpack, rucksack, everything to carry as a traveler. Isn't it? So everything is given life by you. Now you extended the travel. The travel happened in you. So dreamer is the dreamt world, no different. Though you experience the different, you experience the thousands of kilometers, you traveled from Chennai to where? You traveled up to Badrinath. You came from there. So day went, time-wise, space-wise, experience-wise, and the gap-wise, you all those things you experienced, isn't it? So many varieties of different experience, different people, different objects, all those things are given existence by you. They are not other than you. The same way, when you realize the real self, among these all different hands, legs, body, face, and neck, all these different organs, but there is only one conscious. When you become aware about that consciousness alone exists as the body. So you are nothing but your consciousness, and you are the person who gives existence to this body. So this body exists in you, it's not other than you. And as Almighty is nothing but you. When you understand yourself as Atma, as a dreamer in the dream, now you are a waker. So a person who could see all these are nothing but Brahman. That is known as a Brahma Darshanam. So when you see Brahma Darshanam, what will happen? Like the dream. So dream is not understood during the dream, but here you can understand it. So everything is nothing but Brahman alone, because everything is based on the Brahman alone. Brahman alone exists. All these name and forms are, they appear as if existence. Like in the dream. When I come out of the dream, dreamt world, it goes away. But here, when I realize myself, then the world, it becomes equal to the dreamt world, dream world. Then what? You may feel the difference, but those difference will dissolve in the Brahman, in your perception. That's what is told, samagram praviliyate. By having akhandakara brahmavritti, everything is dissolved. Okay, this is one aspect. Another aspect, you know, let me say a few examples. When you want to show your thanks or love to others, how will you show it? You offer some object, you greet them with a gift. That gift, you know, you may give watch, you may give a wall clock, or you may give something like a toy. That toy is not going to be with them always, but you have a bhavana feeling that I am offering my thanks through this object. So this object becomes a tool, isn't it? So when they receive, they also feel that I am receiving the thanks from him in the form of a gift. And he will open the gift with a happy experience, and he will enjoy it, and he will keep in his house somewhere. Sometimes he will keep, and sometimes he will pack and keep the this gift in the wrap. But something is given, something is taken. Something is offered, something is taken. Now, a giver and taker, they are two people. But in the dream, if this incident happens, giver and taker and given and taken, everything is nothing but you, isn't it? The same thing he says, a person, one who has realized everything is nothing but Brahman, for him, giver and receiver, given object and taken object, the karma which is giving, taking, transaction, everything is nothing but Brahman. That's what happens. Everything he could see, that everything praviliyate, samagram praviliyate, in that akhandakara vritti, in that knowledge, everything is dissolved. All the difference are dissolved, all the actions are dissolved, everything is dissolved. What remains? Nothing but Brahman. That's what known as Brahma Yajnam. Yajna means to offer. Offer into the fire. So when you offer into the fire, for your side, from your side, you have been offered. And something is received. And that received things will provide something as a punya phala. In the same way, this person, he looks around. So whatever is given, taken, or received, or whatever is the action which is known as a transaction, for him everything is nothing but Brahman. It's a beautiful expression. But here the taken example is yajna karya, a fire ritual. So fire ritual has got different part of it. A fire ritual needs so many things. A fire ritual needs first a performer of fire ritual and the yajamana. And the instrument means what? You need to have bricks, you need to have sticks, dry sticks which are called a samit, and you need to have prasadas, naividyas, havis, and all those things you need. And you need to have the deity, means God, and you need to have fire, and these all things are having different material in the life, as we have so many equipments in order to live our life. Now, so that person, from the childhood he is performing the yajna. Once he understood he is nothing but Brahman, everything is nothing but Brahman, so he now, when he performs that yajna, so he could dissolve every action into Brahman. He could feel that, oh my God, Yajamana, I am nothing but Brahman. This fire is nothing but Brahman. This havis means the prescribed the material which are offered for in the fire. So that material is nothing but Brahman. Oh, that deity is nothing but Brahman. Whatever I would like to achieve through this yajna, that goal is also nothing but Brahman. Oh my God, everything is Brahman. That is what his inner understanding all about. For him, everything is nothing but Brahman. He has become practical person, though he is endowed with, his ahankara is endowed with various activity. For him, everything is nothing but Brahman. It becomes great havan, great yajna, known as Brahma Yajnam. He offers all the difference. He offers the difference of karta, karma, kriya. He offers all the difference. The doer is nothing but Brahman. He offers in the Brahman. And the materials are nothing but Brahman. He offers in the Brahman. Because his perception is colored, purified with the Brahma Jnanam. Therefore what? All the difference is being offered in this Brahma Akhandakara Vritti. That special understanding what he gets is the great boon in his all karma phalas. All the difference are dissolved in the Brahman. It means what? He doesn't have any karma phala hereafter. For him, everything is nothing but Brahman. So in the among the difference, only what remains is oneness. That oneness is called Advaita Bhavana. That Advaita Bhavana is known as Brahma Bhavana alone. Therefore we call it Brahma Yajnam. This Brahma Yajnam alone will help you to get liberated. That person is already liberated person, because he is not affected by the difference of the Veda of the world. He doesn't have the death, he doesn't have the birth. He considers birth happens in the Brahman. Birth is nothing but Brahman. Like a dreamt world was felt in the dream by the dreamer, and dreamt world and dream are not different. Like in that way, birth and me is not different. Death and me is not different. Birth and death happens in me. I am nothing but Brahman. That is the great understanding by this verse. By the verses past, you know, past six verses, he is being explaining the same thing. Finally, he could have that Brahma Yajnam. That Brahma Yajnam is done by him, by every second of his life. Every second, automatically the Brahma Yajnam is on and on and on. Therefore, he has become Brahma Jnani, Brahma Yogi. He is doing all the yajnas alone, all the time. So he is resolving, he is dissolving all his difference, whatever is achieved by karma. He is dissolving his body, mind and sense complex. He is dissolving his all the actions by the vritti of Aham Brahmasmi. Everything is nothing but Brahman. That is the glory by this verse. It's a wonderful verse. Now you may have the doubt. What is the doubt? Will it be possible to all the people? Why not? It is possible, but we need to have a proper understanding about ourselves. In the last chapter, yajna bhavana, yajnarthat karmanaha, anyatra lokoyam karma bandhanaha. This, the world which we are born in, this world has the nature to bind you, to give bondage to you. This is the only one solution. When you realize yourself is nothing but Brahman, when you realize everything is nothing but Brahman, because all difference, all karma phalas. So in the karma phala, if you have the different attitude, different perception, as they are nothing but Brahman, you are protected, you are valid. Therefore, you know, this Brahman can be taken as a Krishna. Therefore, whoever people, you know, they worship as a Krishna. Everything is nothing but Krishna. They are doing Krishna Yajna. If you pursue as the Brahman, it is called Brahma Yajna. If you replace Brahma as a Krishna, it's a Krishna Yajna. If you see Vishnu, if you see Vishnu in all the aspects, you are doing Vishnu Yajna. That oneness is the point here. That oneness will help us to come across all the karma phalas. And Bhashyakara gives, you know, this world become magic for him. Whatever he wishes, it will happen. That's dharma sankalpa. And Patanjali also says it is dharma megha samadhi. He says that samadhi, there are varieties of samadhi. He will be engaged with good things, yajna, yaga, homa, and doing welfare for all the people. Though he is doing, engaged with lots of activity, he is not affected by any activity like the mud, clay. So when it is made as a pot, when it's made as a big vessel, it doesn't become bound by that shape. Clay remains as the clay. Like, so you may get so many duties in your life, so many characteristics in your life. You are provided so many characters like a father, mother, a husband, wife, brother, sister, friend. You are nothing. All of them, they don't have value to affect you. You may enjoy them, but with the Brahma Akriti understanding. That's all. We will continue the next verse. The next verse also, it talks about Yajna. From this verse, from 24th verse, he introduces 12 kinds of Yajnas. All of them are done research from the different angle. Now, you know, when you study these all verses, you will be amazed. Whatever you do, they also come in these categories, means one of these categories alone. Okay, let us read it. Daivam eva pare yajnam yogina paryupasate brahmagnava pare yajnam yajne naivopajuhvati. So there are people, they say, the devameva apare yajnam. So this jnana yajna stuti is, he is glorifying the jnana yajna. Means the yajna which we done, it is called Brahma yajna. Now he is glorifying that and introducing deva yajna. Deva yajna means what? It's a normal ritual. Normal ritual means what? With all the mantras you might have seen in the temples, with the purpose. See, that person who has converted Yajna into Brahma, he is known as a Brahma Yajna person. Now performing normal Yajna is known as Daiva Yajna. Okay, this Daiva Yajna, they are many in number. So these Daiva Yajnas, if you bring in your life, the life will be benefited more. Now this Daiva Yajna as considering second one. So all other Yajnas we will see in detail in forthcoming sessions. We will meet tomorrow in the same session. Harihi Om. శ్రీ గురుభ్యో నమో నమః. ఓం పూర్ణమద పూర్ణమిదం పూర్ణాత్ పూర్ణముదచ్యతే పూర్ణస్య పూర్ణమాదాయ పూర్ణమేవావశిష్యతే. ఓం శాంతి శాంతి శాంతిః. హరిః ఓం శ్రీ గురుభ్యో నమః. హరిః ఓం. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ.